not is inhuman to kill a cow or a Russian, as it is to kill your mother or neighbor or fellow American. Since men and rats are the only beings that purposely kill their own kind, and we exterminate rats, what does that make us?
What does that make us? What does that make you?
I knew that I was looking for something broader than just a play. At the core of this particular dream was children and their needs, and we knew we needed...
And they came and did a play, and they came for one play. They said, we're going to do this one play, and then we'll be gone. And one play has lasted 25 years.
This is Mark Stickler, and yes. Mark played Scapan in the original production that Cass did
really?
All those years ago.
Hey!
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, they say I have a certain way with words. Wouldn't you tease fancies and pretty deceptions? Lies. Yes.
Do we have to wear wigs too?
Right now, I'm a middle school choir director, and I never thought I would end up teaching middle school kids after seeing how frustrated Bill, of course, always was with us. And I know I made his life a living heck. Just like kids are making my life a living heck now. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing, though. Right now, we're doing a musical theater review right now, and I'm taking all the lessons and all the tools that I learned from being in cast to helping work with these kids.
And this is all that's bothering you too, because this really bothers me about you guys. It does. I mean, these two stingy old geezers want to tell everyone what to do, and it doesn't...
I'm Josh Hofstetter, and I played the Prince's Interpreter in Romeo and Juliet, and I also played Octave in Scapin.
Gentlemen, I'm resolute. Like some big mountain, say or...
Why don't you listen to them?
You know, it really is interesting when you get up there and you actually... you know, do something that's so terrifying, get in front of the audience. In one of the other shows, Scapan, I had to actually start the show, and that terrified me. Because, you know, like, I had to set the momentum, and, you know, Scapan's a show that's all about momentum and cutting people off and this and that, you know. So that was so scary to me to actually think that, oh, God, the lights go up, and that's me. So, it's really interesting. When you put yourself in a position like that, it really does do something... to you that stays with you, and it helps you build confidence in ways that not a lot of other things do.
This letter doesn't make good the friar's words, their course of love, the tidings of
so
the death.
So for Romeo and Juliet, I played the prince's interpreter. Now I was accompanied by Andrew Efkin, if I remember correctly, a really nice guy, and they wanted me to basically say some of the lines for him that he wouldn't be able to say for himself. So it worked really nicely. The costumes were all right, a little embarrassing for my taste in that my mother made it for me. And for Andrew, the color happened to be purple, and I have rather large ears, and I remember that my ears poked out of the sides of the hat that I wore. And, looking back, I think it's interesting now because I'm from Oak Park, so I didn't know at the time, but from other schools, when I tell them that I was in shows like this, they thought that I was like some like theater geek that I got picked on or something. But that wasn't the way it was when we were at Julian. It was actually like, if anything, I thought I was cool for doing it. Which, when I left Oak Park, I realized that that's not a normal thing in other areas.
I'm Ellen Drews. I played Zora in Inspecting Carol in 2004, is the current hypothesis of when that show went on. And
I'm Rachel White. I was not in Inspecting Carol that time around, but I was I watched it, the original one, and I helped the kids out this time around during some rehearsals, so I'm in.
Yeah, so I think overall it seems like sort of the same play. I like was getting ready for all the funny jokes. And you guys are doing a great job of like getting all the jokes and playing them up so that the audience will definitely be laughing. Yeah.
Did you like playing Zora?
I did. I struggled playing Zora though, and you're doing a wonderful job with this. Because Keith was like, oh, she's normal and she's stressed. And I'm used to playing, or at Cass, I was used to playing villains.
cast comes in and says, you're funny, like, let's be creative, let's play games. You write this script with us, and you create something with us, and come hang out in the cast lab, you're cool, like, you have friends here, and you have respect from adults here.
It's really fun how the directors here would give you a character like, oh, you know, here's a script, and they're really, like, for a character like Larry, for instance, you know, this actor that's really into being an actor, but see what you can do with it. And then there was so much freedom associated with that. And every time, and the kids were talking today, it was so funny about apparently someone made a mistake during, like, they said something wrong while making a speech. And it was hilarious, and they kept it. And I remember those sorts of feelings when you would trip up or you would think of something new and you put it in a line, and then they loved it and you kept it, and that was your idea. Mm-hmm. And that's so cool that you have that kind of like agency and power and stuff like that when you know, when you're 13 or 14.
You have to give us that big loving push.
Thank you. And it's because of the brilliance of programs like CAST that keep art alive in our lives. CAST reigns triumphant.
Blackout Queen Enders. Yeah!